purpose of embedded systems. In this purpose of embedded system, first one we are taking it as a data collection and storage and representation. For this, any example if I am taking, the best example for this will be a digital camera. Okay, the embedded system designed for the purpose of data collection performs acquisition of data from the external world. From the external world, you are taking the data and collecting it in your device. That is an embedded system which is designed for. Okay, and data collection is usually done for storage or analysis, manipulation, and transmission. Here, whenever we are seeing with respect to data collection, always you have to do storage and you have to do the analysis with respect to that data, and you have to, if needed, you can do manipulation and also you can do the transmission. Okay, the term data refers all kind of information. It may be text, voice, image, video, anything. Image, video, and electrical signals, and any other measurable quantities. Quantities can be considered as a data. It can be video, audio, text, or electrical signals. Anything can be considered as data. And data can be either analog or digital. Anything can be. See, whatever the data you are taking, that can be analog also, that can be digital also. Digital will be in the form of zeros and ones. Analog will be in the form of continuous form, that is the continuous signal. Okay, the collected data may be stored or transmitted, or it may be processed, or it may be deleted instantly after giving a meaningful representation. Okay, as and when you are getting the data, it can be processed. If it is a raw data, then you have to do processing. That will be after doing the processing, you will get the proper data, and you may delete it instantly after giving the meaningful representation. That is a data collection part. Next, with respect to digital camera, we are going to see that how the data collection, storage, and representation can be done. A digital camera is a typical example of an embedded system with the data collection, storage, representation. Why you people are attending late? Yeah, what we were saying about the digital camera. Digital camera is a typical example of an embedded system with the data collection, storage, representation of a data. Images are captured, and the captured image may be stored within the memory of the camera. Always you will be storing the images within the camera only. The captured image can also be presented in the to the user through the graphic LCD unit. You will be always, nowadays, whatever the cameras we have, everything has a LCD display. By using that LCD display, whatever the images we have taken, that you can verify. You can see through that LCD unit. That is after taking the image. Images will become a data here. If you want to do any processing or not with respect to the image, that also can be done. That is processing. Storage after after the usage of the image, you can transfer it towards any laptop or phone, anything. After transferring, if it is not needed in the device, you can delete also. That is the processing and data collection, storage, and representation. Next, we'll go with the data communication. Embedded data communication system are deployed in application ranging from complex satellite communication system to simple home network systems also. Two type of data communications you can see. One is with respect to long range data communication, that will be taken as an example for satellite communication system. Satellite communication means you will be transferring a data from one device to the satellite, and then you will be waiting for the reply from the satellite. That is with respect to satellite communication. For example, I can tell you with respect to DTH, direct to home is also directly you are taking the data from satellite, and that data will be converted in that digital data will be converted into your television signal, and then you will be watching the TV. That will be related to example related to satellite communication system. To simple home networking systems like your Wi-Fi device, Wi-Fi dongle, or Wi-Fi router, all those things come under home network systems as a data communication application for embedded systems. The transmission is achieved either by a wire medium or by a wireless medium, wired medium or wireless medium. Any transmission you can do by using this embedded systems, okay? And data collecting embedded terminal itself can be incorporate data communication units like a wireless modules, that is Bluetooth, Zigbee, Wi-Fi, Edge, and GPRS, etc., or wireline modules as RS-232, USB, TCP/IP, PS2, etc. will become an example for wireline modules. Okay, wireless modules are Bluetooth and Zigbee, Wi-Fi module or Edge module, GPRS module. All these things will come under the wireless module. If you are going for wired module, RS-232, that is the connection when we are connecting. See, I'll be using laptop with respect to presentations. No, if I am for connecting my display, my laptop connection towards the projector, we are using RS-232 connection. That is actually RS-232. That is a wired connection. No? USB ports are wired connections, and TCP/IP connection is also wired connection. Next is data or signal processing. With respect to this, one example is there, that is a wireless network router for data communication. The network hubs, one second. Don't exit from the class, Ray. Why you people are exiting? Yeah, data communication. Embedded data communication systems are deployed in applications ranging from complex satellite communication systems to simple home networking systems. That is data communication. With respect to this example, we can see that a wireless network router for data communication, that is network hubs, routers, switches, etc., are the typical example for the dedicated data transmission embedded system. They act as a mediator in data communication and provide the various features like data security and monitoring. That is with respect to wireless network routers. That is a network hub. You can take it as an example. Next, we have data or signal processing. Means whatever the data you are getting, the output of the device should be processed signal. Okay, then whatever the type of processing you want to do, you can do it. With respect to what type of input we are giving, the processing will also change. Okay, data or signal processing, the data, voice, image, video, electrical signal, and other measurable quantities collected by the embedded system may be used for the various kind of data processing. It can be done with respect to what type of data we are giving as an input. Embedded system with signal processing functionality are employed in applications demanding signal processing like speech coding, synthesis, audio video decode, and transmission applications, etc. Okay, for example, I will take it as a hearing aid, digital hearing aid. A digital hearing aid is a typical example of an embedded system employing data processing. Digital hearing aid improves the hearing capacity of hearing impaired person. Means normally, if I am taking an example of hearing impaired person, he will not be able to listen to the words which are spoken by the other person. But if the volume is increased, if the resonance is increased, then only it is audible for those people. At that time, you have to do that processing function. It is not possible by natural ears. For that reason, we have to give one external embedded device which will amplify the signal, and also it will resonate the signal, which will reach towards the hearing impaired persons. Okay, that is the actual example which is needed for digital or signal processing format. Next is monitoring. The almost embedded products coming under medical domain are used for monitoring. One second. Almost embedded products coming under the medical domain are used for monitoring. Okay, all the medical embedded systems need a monitoring, because whatever the results we are getting from that, through that results or graphs, whatever the waveform you will get, with respect to that only you have to take the decisions with respect to the health. Okay, for that reason, all the monitoring devices will be related to medical domain. A very good example is an electrocardiogram, that is ECG machine, for monitoring the heartbeat of the patient. The machine is intended to do the monitoring of the heartbeat. It cannot impose control over the heartbeat, but you can't control the heartbeat, but you can see, only monitor it, how it is functioning. And the sensor used in ECG are different electrodes connected to the patient's body. Whenever the ECG is taken, you will be having the different type of sensors which will provide you the actual pulses with respect to the heart. Okay, and some other examples of embedded system with monitoring function are measuring instruments like digital CRO, digital multimeter, logic analyzers, etc., used in control and measurement applications. Whenever we want to measure any information, then you will be using this type of digital devices as an embedded systems, which can monitor the overall functioning of the device or anything. Okay, next is for control. Only here it was only for monitoring, means whatever the data you will get, that one only you have to see. You can't change that data. That is for monitoring. If we are going for control function, embedded system with control functionalities impose control over some variables according to the change in the input variables. Embedded systems with control functionalities impose control over some variables according to the change in the input variables. Whatever the input variables you are giving, input values you are giving, with respect to that, the functioning of the device will also change. That will come under control section of embedded system. A system with control functionality contains both sensors and actuators. Means whatever the input I am giving, that should be sensed by the sensors. Whatever the output it is giving, by using the actuators, it will be giving the results. Sensors are connected to the input port for capturing the changes in the environmental variables or measuring variables. The actuators connected to the output port are controlled according to the changes in the input variables to put an impact on the controlling variables to bring the controlled variable to the specified range. That is related to your sensor and actuators in the controlled range of embedded systems. An air conditioner system used to control the room temperature to a specified limit is a typical example for an embedded system for control purpose. If you want to do the controlling function and all, that air conditioner systems are a main example. Some of the air conditioners you have with the room temperature checking also. If the room temperature reaches more than 27, automatically the air condition will switch on. That is the main application of controlling. First, it will sense that room temperature is more than 27 or not. If it is more than 27, automatically the air conditioner will switch on. Sensing temperature is done by a sensor. Switching on the AC air conditioner system will become a actuator function. A air conditioner contains a room temperature sensing element. That's why always it will be checking, continuously it will be checking the room temperature, which may be a thermistor or a handheld unit for setting up the feeding, the device desired temperature. Means all the air conditioning device won't be having the temperature sensor to verify the actual temperature and to increase the reduce the temperature of the room or to cool down the room. Some of the devices, some of the air conditioners will be having, it won't check for the external temperature, but it will give the manual input. You can give the manual input by using the remotes and all to whatever the temperature you need in that room, you can set it with respect to that. Next, we have application specific user interface. In this, these are embedded systems with application specific user interfaces like buttons, switches, keypads, lights, bells, and display units, etc. All those things come under application specific user interfaces. For example, you can take it as a mobile phone. You will be giving the input, you will be taking the output, you will have a switches, you will be having the different type of display units, you will be having the lights, everything. Okay, in a mobile phone, the user interface is provided through the keypad or graphical LCD module, system speaker, or vibration alert. All these things are the interfaces from the user towards the device. Okay, a mobile phone is an example for embedded system with application specific user interfaces. That means with respect to the application, you will be having the user interface. Okay, and next we have a typical embedded system model. If I am taking a typical embedded system, what all things will be present in your actual embedded system? Main thing will be your system core, whatever the core operating systems, or if you want, that will be stored here. And then you will be having the input ports as a sensors, that may be switches, or that may be any temperature sensor, pressure sensor, or any other sensors you can see here. That is an input port sensors. With respect to the input port, you will be having the output port. That is, output ports are actuators. Means with respect to the input value which is given by the sensor, actuator will perform. Okay, that is buzzer, light, switching on the light, switching on the AC. All those things come under actuators. Okay, other supporting integrated circuit and subsystems, whenever you need extra input or extra processing sections, then you need other supporting integrated circuits. Okay, and memory, embedded firmware is also included in this memory, and whatever the data transmissions or data manipulations can be done this on this memory area. In this system core, the main how it is created means using FPGA, ASIC, DSP, SOC, microprocessor or microcontroller. Any one type of the method is used to create your system core. Okay, communication interfaces, that is serial or parallel, whatever the type of communication interfaces that you can see can be connected through system core. Okay. The other supporting integrated circuits and subsystems will be added to system core. A typical embedded system, it contains the single chip controller, which acts as the master brain of a system. The controller can be a microcontroller, microprocessor, a field programmable gate array device, and digital signal processing DSP, an application specific integrated circuit, that is ASIC, and application specific standard product ASSP are the single chip micro contains the which act as a master brain of the system. The controllers can be all this. An embedded system can be viewed as a reactive system. The control is achieved by processing the information coming from the sensors and user interfaces and controlling some actuator that regulate the physical variable. See, this control is achieved by processing the information, whatever you are giving as an input from sensors and user interfaces and controlling some actuators. We can regulate the physical variables by using this input. Okay. And keyboards, push button switches, etc. are example for common user interface input devices. Whatever the user interfaces we are having with respect to embedded system are mainly keyboard and push button switches. Whenever you want to give an input or get an output, you need to have this keyboards and push buttons. Okay. And LEDs or liquid crystal display, piezoelectric buzzers, etc. are example for common user interface output devices for typical embedded system. These LEDs and liquid crystal display and piezoelectric buzzers are the some common example for the common user interface output devices for typical embedded system.